be in your own body, be in your own space. And, you know, as we do come into movement together, just giving yourself the time to let your practice be exactly what you need this morning. And if that means that you just lay on the floor for the next, you know, 75 minutes or so, that's absolutely fine. I'm just feeling the warmth of the room, starting to feel that shift in the weather outside. I know some of you are more familiar with Ayurveda than others, and it doesn't matter, but me at this time of year is the vata. It's that kind of like flighty energy of all the shift of the weather, the leaves falling, blowing around, the windy weather. It can make us feel ungrounded, and just in general, life can certainly make us feel ungrounded, but particularly at this time of year, it can be something that can be interesting to deal with. But try to think of it as an opportunity to shed those things that are no longer serving you, so you can kind of hibernate on it in the winter and then grow anew in the spring. So from here, just let yourself start to walk your hands over to one side of your mat, just starting to lengthen out your rib cage. It doesn't matter which side first. I'll be more specific in size later. And then if you'd like, you know, kind of play with the push and pull of your hands of how that might lengthen out your ribs a little bit differently, or shorten the ribs for that matter. And letting yourself see if you need to ease back onto your heels more in the child's pose, or if it would actually feel better to let yourself pull forward a little bit. And then when it feels right, start to work yourself down the center line, and then eventually start to come on up and over to the other side. But know that you can always go at your own pace, pause any place you want to a little longer. Give it a couple breaths to lengthen out through your side body, and just kind of being aware of how one side of your body is feeling compared to the other, and more just as you progress in the practice, so you can kind of honor that. And then when you feel more balanced or as close as you're going to get at the moment, you can let yourself come forward and just start to shift towards the position of hands and knees, and just letting yourself try to gently move through the shapes of cat and cat, and letting yourself kind of go with the inhales and exhales as it feels right for you. Sometimes I like to focus on the inhale and the rounding of the spine predominantly for that activation through the belly, but a lot of times, you know, you'll be cued or your own body might feel more natural to exhale. Just know it's right wherever you want to do. And as you're letting yourself kind of move along your spine a bit, giving yourself the opportunity that if you want to incorporate any other movement of your head and neck or your shoulders, your hips, I tend to like to make this kind of a full body action, just kind of rolling out all the bits that might be feeling tight, you know, from your body being in a position, whether sleeping, moving, working out, whatever you've already got going on today. And then eventually let yourself come on into a long spine. If it's a lot on your wrist, you might even pull back a little bit. Taking your right hand, rotate it so your thumb is facing out and your fingers are facing towards you. And depending on your wrist, it might be okay to do both hands at the same time, but if not, just do one and I'll still tell you a chance to switch. You can kind of shift the weight back and forward, just kind of seeing where you get the best sensation. And if you, since everybody does get the heel of the hand down, just be mindful that you're hyperextending or locking your elbow. You might even give it a soft bend, and just notice how that might actually feel better. And then when you're ready, you can release the one hand, switch to the other, or if you're doing both and you need a break, feel free to take the break. I'm just kind of being aware of the difference of one side to the other. And if you need a little less, if you kind of pull your body weight back and then put your hands down, so it's almost more like you're seated, that will help too. And then when you're ready to, you can release both hands. You might just stand on your shins for a moment and just kind of roll out your hands. And if you'd like a little bit more, so you might interlace your fingers and roll them out. It's a little trick from Elizabeth. And then just take a moment, and just while you're on the shins, just sweep the arms up high, and you can sit on your heels if that's more comfortable. Just exhale, let the right hand come down, left arm up or over, just getting a little deeper stretch in your side legs. And then however it feels comfortable, just circle the left hand down, right arm up, just let yourself open up through your side body. And then here, when your right hand comes down, just let your hands come to the low back. Not a huge back bend yet, unless it's just really comfortable for you. Just lift the chest, just getting that sensation of opening up the heart a bit. And then really use your belly to help engage, drawing back up. Let yourself pull back up. And then maybe sit back in child's pose, or if you prefer, puppy or child's pose, any of the above. And then we're going to come all the way out towards our stomach. So just however that feels right for you, rolling all the way out to your back. If you have things directly near your head, you might decide you want to shift them out of the way. Just take your right hand out to the side, and then rotate your right palm to the ceiling. Bending the left knee, let your left toes roll behind the right. And you can play with, like, the more of your body that faces the ceiling, the deeper the stretch. So if you actually place both feet on the floor, some people like to clasp the hands behind the back. Feel free to add in those elements that you like. And then when you're ready to, just come back down towards your belly. Slide that right hand in, and then just extend it straight out in front of you. Bend your right knee out to the side like a tree. That's a little twist of moment. And then take your left hand right underneath your right, and then just roll onto your back. So the end result is you're just doing a twist with your right leg dropping over. I was so excited. After the hurricane, not that I was black, my guard of power, I lost some leads, but lost some leads. And you know how whenever I do this, I always say someone should be fanning me?
I got to do it.
You're another breath. And then come back to your belly, and if it's okay, keep your left arm underneath you. And then it's going to give you a little deeper stretch there. If you keep the right knee bent to the side, that kind of smooshes your chest to the ground more. And in that case, it might also be really uncomfortable on your chest, so be nice. And then let your right leg meet the left leg. Press into your right hand enough. You can draw the left arm out without too much resistance. And then just come back over. Any variation, whether on forearms, hands, whatever feels good. Actively press into your feet, your legs. Give it another breath. And then yogi's choice. Relax and either pause on your belly, or if you feel like you'd rather come into table and kind of wiggle out your hips, your back for a moment, go right ahead. We're going to come back to the belly in a second. And then when you feel ready to, you can extend your left arm out to the side. Turn your left palm to face up towards the ceiling. Right hand comes under your shoulder, and then just roll your right toes behind you. And again, you might find one side has more resistance than the other. For me, it's this side for sure, because it's my dominant side. But, you know, let yourself have that space to try to find balance rather than overdoing where it feels really mobile and not giving yourself the space to explore where you might need it more. And then easy peasy, come back down towards your belly. Slide your left hand forward out in front of you, and then right arm underneath. And then left knee coming out to the tree. That just makes it easier to roll onto your back. And then just coming into the twist. If you need a little less of a twist, you can bring the knee to the sky. This might feel deeper just because your hip is a little bit more grounded into the floor when you roll than if you did it from your back. Take another inhale and just maybe sigh a little. Just let it go. And then you can come back down to your belly with the left knee bent or straight. And then, again, readjust as you need to be comfortable, because it can be a lot on your right shoulder or on your chest, in effect. And then you start to work your left hand in towards you. Lift up enough to slide your right arm out. And then cobra, or if you're feeling up dog, you're more than welcome to. Just giving yourself some space to lengthen. And then take a pause to lower down. And either hands and knees, or if you're ready, letting yourself come up and back into downward facing dog. And just take a moment in whatever shape you happen to have come into, just to unwind a little, and totally in your own way. I'll come back to cueing in a couple of moments, but giving yourself some space to walk out your legs, maybe it's a little shake of the head, you come up on the tippy toes and grab the heels again. I'm starting to unwind your spine. And here, my intention is for hands to go to feet, but it really doesn't matter. Just letting your feet come to hands, hands come to feet. Just coming into a forward fold for a moment. And bend your knees as much as you need to feel comfortable. You can let your arms just kind of opposite elbow or just straight down towards the ground. Letting gravity do a little bit of the work to open your neck. Give a shake out of your head. And then let your right hand come down, soften the right knee.
Really?
What's the easiest?
And then come back up to the center, sweep up high. And if you're comfortable, arms up, go right ahead. But if not, maybe hands to low back. Again, just a gentle back bend, just enough to feel that stretch across the belly. And then it's nice and easy. Let yourself just come on back. Maybe hands to the heart, just taking a second to pause. And as we come into movement, know that your voice in your own head and your own body is the important one to listen to. It's telling you to do something other than what I'm saying. Let yourself be in a space to honor what you need. When you're ready to inhale, draw the arms up to the sky. On the exhale, just simply forward fold. However you need to get to down dog, so whether you're walking against forward or walking feet back, just pause there for a moment. On the inhale, roll forward towards a high push-up. You're welcome to lower shins. Press up and back to down dog. Try to find that lift from your belly. Roll forward towards a high push-up. Pull up and back to down dog. One more time. Now this time from the high plank, your choice. You can stay still or take chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing or cobra, and then eventually downward facing dog, taking the hips up nice and high to the sky. On your inhale, take your right leg up to the sky. Bend the knee, open the hip, and just literally let it do whatever you feel naturally it wants to do. Whether it's circling it around, rolling your toes, maybe it's just letting it kind of hang. And then ease that foot down to the earth, and then just check out the other side. And just giving yourself a chance just to notice how one side might be feeling compared to the other. Really mindful in your movement. So that way you can just kind of pay attention to the action of it, not just what you hear me tell you to do. And then here you can lower both of your feet down towards the earth. One more time, either feet to hands or hands to feet, just coming into that forward fold again. Soften the left knee, left hand down, right arm to the sky. Again, whether it's to your hip or up to the ceiling, it's up to you. And then let the right hand come on down, left arm up, and give yourself some room to play with the placement of your hips, your legs, how much are you bending your knees or lengthening your legs. Forward fold, and this time perhaps poke your big toes, and coming in Padmasana, just pushing down with the feet, a little pull up with the arms. Bend your knees as much as you need to, and then just exhale, let yourself sink in. Inhale, come all the way up to standing, just slow and steady. And then exhale, let the hands come on each other. Just diving a bit deeper to the flow, inhale, reach up. Exhale, and forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. On the exhale, walk yourself up to down dog, whichever way you have to go. Roll forward to a high push-up, now this time a little bit different. Lower down the shins. Walk your hands back to your knees, and inhale, sweep your arms up to the sky. Exhale, right hand down, right arm up and over. And then left hand circles down, let that right arm come. Then let the hands come around to your low back, whatever amount of stress on the camel feels appropriate for you. And then exhale, sit back, child's pose just for a moment. If you're comfortable with it, reach towards your heels, crown of the head coming down to the mat, and just lift your hips. It's called hero pose, hero of the bunny. And then let your hips sit down. Walk your arms forward like you're coming to child's pose, but instead, shift forward and hands and knees, and then Anamatasana puppy pose, letting your hands walk a little further forward. But child's pose is fine if that's more comfortable for you. Then you use your belly to roll yourself forward, come on down toward your side. Take your right arm out to the side, because this time bend the right elbow. And I think all of you know this, so just go a little more cautious, you're going to have a lot less range of motion than you got busy. Left toes roll behind you. Give it a breath or two. And then totally take your time, because all we're going to do is the other side. Come back down towards your belly. Left arm can extend, get a slight bend in the elbow this time. Right hand presses, right foot rolls. And if you need to, you can always shift your arm a little forward, a little back, for more or less resistance. Step, hop, or float your feet up towards your hands. And then Tadasana, standing up. arms up to the sky. On the exhale, forward fold. Very approaching. Inhale, take a halfway lift. Exhale, chaturanga. High to low, right to low, or you're welcome to skip it. Inhale, urdhva mukha, upward facing. And then exhale, ottoman, downward facing. Giving yourself a pause there. Right. Give yourself a moment just to kind of hang out, be where you are. Soften along your jaw. And then as you're ready, gaze forward, soften the knees, step forward, and hop your feet towards your hips. Halfway lift is the in breath, and then exhale back. All the way up to standing, as much of a back bend as you want at the top. And then exhale, hands halfway to the heart. So two more, totally at your own pace. Inhale, Urdhva Vistasana. Exhale, bow, Uttanasana. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana. Nice. Exhale, Chaturanga. And then here, come all the way around. I'll face the same way for the moment. Turn lower down your left shin, and then just take a breath and draw the arms up. Let the right hand come down, left arm up and over, like we were doing standing. And then left arm down, I have no idea what this song is. Let this right arm come on up and over. Now, your call, either arms to the sky, kind of opening up through the back bend, or if it feels better in your back, hands can go low. But see if you can peel the heart up and sink the hips a little bit, just to get a little bit more juice from the front of that left quad. And then take an inhale, draw the arms up to the sky. Exhale, let the hands come down to the mat, downward facing dog. Let's take that right leg up to the sky. Bend the knee, open the hip, anything that feels good for you there. Good. And then lower the right leg to meet the left leg. Your call, either stay still for a pause or slide forward to high plank. Chaturanga, if you're feeling it or any transition you want. Inhale, heart rising. And then all the way up the back, downward facing dog. I think you all know enough to know that I totally embrace you doing what you want to do, so don't be afraid to do your own thing. Inhale, take the left leg to the sky. Coil the left knee into your belly and just heading up to warrior one. Heel is grounded mostly for balance if you'd rather be in a lunge. Arms are up. And then exhale, let your arms rest back. Inhale, sweep up. Exhale, let your arms come back. Inhale, sweep up. One more time, let your arms come back and then kind of pause there. Think of it like your chest is floating just above your thigh. Either stay like this or left arm back, right arm forward. And just notice how your right obliques probably have to fly around a little bit differently to help support you. Give it a breath there, and if and when you wish, switch the arms. Bring another reach, just kind of feel that lengthening through your side body, the stability through both of your legs. And then yogi's choice, either arms forward or arms back. Forward is a little more stressful on your back, so feel free to support yourself. Give it a breath where you are. And then as you're ready, hands can come down, pivot to the right. Just that little side-to-side lunge, chance to unwind the legs. It can be as high or as low as you want it to be. And then the next time you bend your left leg, start to pivot back to the front of the room, lowering down the right shin, and that's mostly for balance. Inhale, sweep your arms up. Left arm down, right arm climbs up and over. You're starting to feel the length of your side body. Right arm down, left arm up. And then when you come down the center line, your call. Both arms to the sky, both arms to the low back, even both arms to the floor. But see, maybe there's a little more room to sink into this. And then you can circle the arms around and down, pressing through the hands, take up and back, down dog, left leg up to the sky. Bend the knee, open the hip, or if there's another variation you'd like to do, you're welcome to. And then just lower both of your feet down towards the earth. Your call, step, hop, or float your feet up towards your hands. On the inhale, take a halfway lift, and then just exhale, and down. Come all the way up to sandwich, sweeping to the sky, and then just exhale, hands come up. Step your feet a little bit closer. So here, just twist to the right, and then just take a second to get comfortable in your own body. And that might mean you're twisting high, that might mean you want to get a deeper breath. I'm planning on a different arm balance today, you can certainly use side throw if you're feeling it, but just don't feel any pressure, but really what you need in this particular moment. Soften your jaw. And when you're ready to inhale, come to the center, you might decide to stand tall. And then on your exhale, switch over towards the left. And kind of give yourself a chance just to notice, like, what feels different on this side? Is it better? Is it a little bit more sticky? And try not to use judgment around it, just be aware of it, respect it. Give it another inhale, and maybe the exhale will twist you a little deeper, maybe. And then come back in towards the center. And then just exhale, forward fold, just let it all go. Take a second, separate your feet a little bit. Just keep your hips a little bit open. So we're not coming up into bird of paradise, just to kind of give you that heads up, but it's going to have similar elements for a second. Let your right hand come down towards your right foot. Let the left arm reach to the sky, and then maybe wrap around to your low back.
Now, don't worry about if you can bind or not, but if you want to sneak the right hand up to grab the left hand, you can. But all you're going to try to do is twist a little bit deeper the left shoulder to the sky. So my hands aren't touching, if that makes it feel better to you. Left hand can even stay on the ground. But you're just using the stability of your right arm pressing into the right leg to help you twist deeper. And then when you're ready, you can exhale, come to the center. Just hang in for a second, or if you need to relax for a moment, go right ahead. And then again, left hand down. Bending the left knee helps. Right arm up to the sky. If you're trying to get that wide or suck some of it, turn the palm behind you and let it come towards your left hip. And then maybe the left arm sneaks up underneath or just kind of presses to the inside of your left thigh. And then just let yourself roll right cheek, right shoulder to the ceiling. Try to give yourself the space you need so you can breathe. And then just simply exhale, forward fold. Take an inhale with a halfway lift. Exhale however you want to get to down dog. So feel free to skip the chaturanga up dog or take it from the waist up. Go with it however you like to. We'll be eventually in downward facing dog. And then take your feet hips distance, give or take. Spin your heels to the left. And either with straight legs or bend your knees, just kind of press your heels towards the earth. And just more so you can get deep stretch in the side of your body. It's not about your heels touching. And then come on to the center, heels drop to the opposite side, knees can be bent or straight, lengthening through your ribcage, really pressing out through your hands. And then come back in towards the center. On the inhale, take your right leg up to the sky. Step the right foot forward, coming once again into warrior one. Down the left heel, and then just reach the arm side. And if you're exhale, let your hands come on back. Let them rest in your low back. Just so you can kind of feel your chest rising, but lengthening of the tailbone. Now there is going to be a moment of warrior three. If you're not feeling it today, just keep the left heel on the floor. Roll up on the ball of the left foot, and then let yourself shift the weight forward. Now like you did when you were balanced, take the right arm back and the left arm forward. Good. Now perhaps switch the arms. Switch the arms one more time. Left arm forward. To your left arm back. Good. Now here, let your left foot come back down, sort of slowly lengthen the right leg. Reach the left arm high. And then just reach out. You can bring your right hand to hip or extend it behind you. And then coming into your variation of revolve triangle. Now I know we haven't done a ton to actually stretch the hamstring yet, so if you feel like you want to bend into the knee, go right ahead. You're pretty, you've got a few twists going on, the harder you're blocks are always a good thing. Give yourself a breath here. Really nice. Now when you're ready to come on down, let your right shoulder come down. Turn to the long edge of the mat and bend your back knee. And then once you get there, let yourself take the right hand down and left arm up to the sky. So you have that bent knee and you're just opening up. Your right is as far as I do. Give another breath. Now I'm going to do the second part so you can see it. Let the left arm come on down. Bend your right knee. So you're still actually facing the long edge of your mat. Either take your right hand to your thigh and use that to help you twist. Or if you want, pick up your left arm and bring the elbow to the outside of your thigh. It's kind of like you're doing a revolve side angle with your feet a little more balanced. Whatever degree of rolling the right chest open that feels good for you, don't overdo it. Give it a breath. Now here, just to get a moment of break up of this leg, shift up and over, bend your left knee, but look at your right foot. So look towards the windows. And then turn your right toes forward and just come on into warrior two. Take a breath here, reverse the warrior, however that feels right for you. And then come on up and over, side angle. Give yourself a breath, just a pause. And now your choice, you can either stay still, or if you prefer to pulse in and out of the pose, go right ahead. Just think of it be about three more breaths in case that makes any difference in your decision. Then on your next inhale, pull yourself back up to warrior two. Face in the front of the room, exhale your hands down to the mat, downward facing dog. Take your right leg up to the sky, bend the knee, open the hip. Any of that good juicy stuff that you like to do. And then lower the right toes, meet the left foot. And then your choice, either stay like you are, or chaturanga up, dog, down dog, or subtle one. It doesn't have to be your deepest variation. Maybe you're keeping the hand towards the hips, giving your hips room to sway. Maybe you're really lengthening out the rib cage. Yeah, kind of check out how it feels in your body. Especially depending on other things that you do with your life. Give it a breath here. Now as we come undone, we're going to roll towards the right. Turn to the right, you can shift up and over, bending your back knee. And bending your front knee. The next time you bend the back knee, the right knee, just let your left hand come down. Right hand can come to the hip, to the side, or your thigh. And then here, as you come around towards the front, this way we're going to cause a deeper twist option. Right hand might stay down, or you might take the elbow or your arm towards your left thigh, and then roll your left shoulder up. You could lengthen the front leg. I didn't cue that the first time, but for purposes of what we're going to do later, you might want to keep it that. And then when you're ready to come on down, just shift to the right leg for a second to get out of that hip, and then pivot the left toes forward, coming into warrior two. You can reverse the warrior. And then coming up and over, side angle. And then your choice, either enjoy in one of the poses or the other, or letting yourself flow in and out for a couple of breaths. You can play with the arm variations if you'd like to stabilize your upper belly. Next inhale or so, we'll pull you back to the warrior two shape. And then just exhale your hands down to the mat, down dog, taking the left leg up to the sky. Feel free if you ever want to flip or add anything in like that, you're welcome to. And then eventually we're going to be coming up to standing. So step, hop, or float, feet toward your hands, however you would like to. Give yourself a moment just to sink in. Come all the way up to stand. And then exhale, hands in towards the horizon. So this time you will have the option to stand up in the lower part of the if you want. Just know it's an option. Inhale, sweep up to the side. I'll face the same way so it's not confusing. Exhale and fold. Soften your right knee, right hand down, left arm up to the sky. Now rotate your left palm behind you so it can come to rest at your left, your right hip. Right hand can sneak underneath. Now don't worry, if you can't catch the bind, it doesn't matter. Hold on to your hamstring. And then either stay and just continue to roll the left shoulder to the sky, or if you want, lower the left shoulder a little bit, step the right toes in a tap, and then maybe come to stand. And you might just be standing in kind of a fancy tree, or you can extend the leg. Don't be afraid to do something that feels interesting to you.
That was a good face, too.
Yeah, make your faces out loud. I'm a strong supporter of sound effects, too. That's excellent. No, that's it. You got it. That's right. Up and down. At all, I can't do it to save my life at the moment, so let the right arm come around. Left hand can come through. And then again, shifting into the right foot. That shift of the weight is what helps with the balance. And then just start thinking about engaging through your belly, not just using your left arm to pull up the left leg. Yes. And as you decide, you can more stable on. Usually.
That's it.
Very pretty expressions. Good. Look at that.
Let yourself come to the center.
more time, right leg up to the sky. Coming forward into warrior one. Maybe press into your left shin, your right foot, coming into Parabasana, or just lift that right arm we're just going to end up in down dog. If you want to take the transition, I'm going to say, you're going to turn so you're facing the front of the mat. Your left leg is down. You're going to give a little lift up and then start to pick up that right leg. Standing split and then down dog. And you're looking at any whatever, just down dog. Yeah. Up to you, side of the foot. Yes. And then your choice, your right hand. Your choice, down dog and pause for a second. Or if you'd like to try to up dog, down dog, or whatever transition, you just have one more side to go. And then taking your time. Left leg will start to reach to the sky. And then eventually, you're across the line, where you want. Draw your arms in. And you can let the arms come back by your side. Now, the arms are intended to help stabilize you, but if you're just finding them distracting, you can let it go. Let the right arm come forward, left arm come back. And then switch. And then maybe using that to help you start to pick up the right leg. Usually when the right arm is forward, it'll help you feel more balanced. You might switch the arms one more time. And then right arm forward, left arm back, starting to shift into paprika, which adjusts them. Just letting yourself come into the ball tap room. And again, I'm keeping it pretty simple myself, keeping the hand in the hip rather than the sky, but you know, you're trying to keep your hips relatively even while you roll the ribcage open, which honestly is quite hard to do. Give it another breath or so. Now when you're ready to come undone, I'm going to look different than you because I'm facing you. I'm going to start to let the right toes come down. Pivot up and over and come into warrior two of your right leg, your back leg, just to get the weight off that hip for a second. And then here you can turn the right toes in. Warrior two over the left leg. Now, I'm saying warrior two, but it's really more keep your toes facing the side of the room. If you want to do the arm balance business, left hand to left hip, right arm up. And then bring that right elbow to the outside of your left leg. Now seriously, you don't have to do anything with the arm balance, you can just roll your chest open. But if you want to try to experiment, heel toe your left foot in a bit closer, and then start to let your hands come down. And then just think of, don't think your arms are supporting you, it's your legs balancing you out. So just letting your legs press behind you, that's a joy, you had it. You had it, yeah, that's a thing. Make those legs strong, I'll hold you up. Good, that's it. And then letting yourself slowly unwind, you can come back into the middle. Forward fold, or maybe rather go side to side, a goddess moment. Might feel good in your hips. Just giving yourself a moment to kind of sink in. Shake out that head. Oh, I just saw myself in the camera. This is an interesting view. Good. Now, take an inhale. Just start to think about a halfway lift. No rush. Take a peek over your left shoulder, and then start to come around towards the front of the mat. Lower down your right shin, let the arms come up. Now left hand might come to your left hip, right arm can come across, and you can simply hold the twist here. Maybe you want to move the left foot to the right edge of your mat and try to bring that right elbow around. And another little trick is if you pull the left foot closer to you, it just makes it easier to get your hands down to the ground. But once you get there, try to separate your legs as soon as you can. Yes. Spread it. Yeah, there it is. So use your head. Wow. And when you come undone, you can let yourself pull back. Just lengthen your left leg. Letting yourself. It's funny. For all the years that I've been teaching yoga, I'm saying yoga, whatever. Let yourself start to shift back. You can start to find that kind of tree shape. But I'm like, oh no, it doesn't make any difference with your body's like. Let your right hand come down, your shin come down. There's a moment in standing split. And then the feet come on back. But if you'd rather just go back and down dog, feel free to get there however you want to get there. And then eventually, I'm going to step or float through towards sitting. And then just take a moment coming down toward your back. I'm going to do a little bit of core, but it can simply just be a chance to lengthen your side waist if you prefer. So let your arms come on out by the side. I think we might have done something like this last week. And then pull your knees in towards your belly. Now, if you'd rather just chill, let your legs drop to one side and just let them fall. If you want to work the core a little bit more, hover your legs and try to squeeze your knees towards each other. And then think knees towards your chest as they come through the center, and then up and over towards the left. And then just letting yourself go side to side. Now, as you're doing this, you can keep your knees bent the whole time. Some of you might decide to lengthen one or even both of your legs as you're twisting and either bend or straight through the center, or letting yourself keep both legs long the whole time. But really think about, especially if you lengthen the legs, pushing out to the top foot to try to keep your hips nice and even. Going side to side a handful of times, kind of just depends on how fast or slow you're going. I'm going to say about four more, but just know we're going to meet in the middle if we decide to stop whenever you would like to stop. And then the next time you come to the middle, let your left foot come to the mat, let your right leg come to the sky. Now, reach up with your hands towards your right foot, but don't worry about trying to catch your foot itself. Just hold your leg and you can get your comfort. Now, if you'd rather just focus on the hamstring stretch, just draw the leg gently towards you. If you want to make this a little more core, press your right leg away so your head and shoulders start to come off the mat. And then if you'd like to, float the left leg. Now you can either keep holding onto the right leg or extend your arms. And then just try to pulse up a little higher. Hands can also be behind the head if you feel like you want support for your neck. Here's 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, hold up. Switch legs. Switch legs. Switch legs, switch legs, switch legs, switch legs, both legs up. Reach your hands up towards your feet, like you can touch them, but try not to pull your feet to your face. One more breath, and then just relax for a second. You can stretch out long if you'd like to. We're going to start with the other leg in a moment. And then when you're ready, right foot down, left leg to the sky. Again, you might just choose to chill and stretch out your left hamstring. That's an awesome decision. Or hold on to the leg and push the leg away so your head and shoulders start to curl off the mat. Floating the right leg is optional. Letting go of the leg is optional. Good. And then just give a little pulse. Little pulse. Little pulse. Little pulse. Pulse. 4, 3, 2, hold up. Switch legs. Switch legs. Switch legs. Switch legs. For 4, 3, 2, both legs up. Reach up towards your toes, but try not to pull your toes closer to your face. And then slowly just relax it down. Excellent job. It would probably feel pretty spectacular to either lengthen out or come into bridge or something if you'd like to. And then here, please don't worry if you don't have a strap, but if you have a strap or a towel, you might want it. Let yourself just bend your left knee for a moment, place it on the ground, and take your right hand and reach up to your right foot. Big toe, whatever you can reach comfortably. Now, your call, we're going to drop the right leg out to the right, and then you decide if you're going to keep the left leg bent or you want to lengthen the left leg down to the mat. And don't worry, if you don't have a strap or it's a lot, kickstand your right arm so you can just support your right leg out to the side. Think of it like you're doing triangle where you're going to lay down. Give it a couple of breaths and try to let yourself soften. Sometimes here, if we're really tight, we tend to tense up, and that just makes it harder, especially when you're in an exposed position. I'm guessing you all know what's on this. So, I didn't encourage you doing a really deep revolve triangle standing because I knew we were going to do it laying down. So, here, let the leg come up. You can switch it to your left hand. And then, your call, because you can always bend the knee if you need to. Kind of play with lengthening out through that right side of your waist as the right foot comes over to the left. if you want, worry less about reaching your foot and think more about bringing your right shoulder to the ground. And breathe. That's a little thing too. And then take your time, come on up into the center, and then one more time, draw the right leg towards you. And whatever degree of hamstring opening feels good, you can pick your head up to your shin. Some of you might bring the leg down to the floor. Just take care of you. And then when you're ready to unwind it, you can just let both legs come down to the ground for a moment. Still to this day will always fascinate me how longer it feels on one side than the other. And then starting the left leg, bend the right knee, place the right foot on the floor, just for the space to begin with. And then reach down towards the left foot, left toe, left leg out to the side. This is perfect. Or if you want to straighten out the right leg on the mat, just give yourself the option. Try to soften them on your jaw. Feel free to close your eyes, just go inward. Switching hands, bending the knee as necessary, just letting the left leg come over to the right. I like to use my left hand kind of in the hip crease to try to draw my left hip away from the ribs to lengthen it out. Feel like two more breaths. Can the left shoulder come a little closer to the earth? You can press into your right elbow to sneak the right shoulder out. That will help. And then when you are ready to come on back to the center, you can reach down towards your left leg and then just whatever degree of hamstring opening that feels good to you. So give yourself the chance to draw the leg in.
It's okay if you fall down and lose your spark. Just make sure that when you get back up, you rise the whole damn fire. Just giving yourself a moment to deepen your breath. Very consciously feel how it moves in and out of your body. Just if it feels appropriate for you, maybe reach your arms. Let them kind of go up towards the ceiling and towards the back of the room or in front of the room, and then extend through your legs so you get in that first full morning stretch. Like you might see a cat or a dog, you can try to stretch every piece of your body apart. And then when you feel ready to exhale, maybe you let yourself curl into a ball and come to your side, or just stay on your back and draw into a ball, whatever it feels like for you. Eventually coming up into a seat, but if you're really more comfortable laying down, we're going to do a brief pranayama, brief breathing exercise, so if you'd rather stay on your back, you're more than welcome to. There's more traditional ways of doing this, Nadi Shodhana, but I'm going to teach you a maybe not as traditional variation, just because it's kind of nice when you're sweaty and maybe even a little congested. Just let your hands come down to either rest on your thighs or rest by your side with the palms facing up. And then just take a moment, let your right hand lightly close, and just take an inhale and kind of envision it coming through the left side of your body. At the top of the breath, just hold both hands closed. if you're finding it beneficial, take a couple more rounds like that. Don't worry if you open or close your hands at different times. Nothing bad will happen. It's just a way to kind of balance out your energies. And frankly, if you're just trying to bring more energy in, just focus on breathing in and out to the right. And if you need to kind of calm it down, breathe in and out to the left. And switching is for balance. When it feels like it's an appropriate moment for you to just pause and let your hands come to your heart or any other mudra that feels like a comfortable seal for you. And bow in the head to the heart. And just remember, as we start to shift into the change of seasons, and you know, it starts to get a little darker earlier, a little colder, a little stays dark a little later. So don't let anything at all, dim your light within. Take a big inhale. Exhale the sigh. Thank you. Thank you so much for taking the time to come to your mat and choosing that time to be here with me. Together we'll say namaste. If you have any questions about anything you did, please don't hesitate to ask. I hope you don't mind. I touched you all at once. I was just excited to walk around that. Don't worry. If you're not comfortable with me doing that, don't worry to tell me that. Totally fine. Just figured I'd...